Hello everyone. Coming to the most frequently asked question, which is what are the benefits of homeschooling really, and why would I go for it, and also the IGCSE, I mean the benefits of IGCSE and homeschooling. So I'm going to actually take this and answer this in parts. So I'm going to use the 5 W's and 1 H to answer this. In today's video, I'm going to talk about the H, which is the how to study. So how you study, our child studies, is completely different in the IGCSE curriculum and on Wolsey Hall, Oxford. So if you take subject-wise, for example, English, because that I won't start with that because that's the one which is radically different from how, we have studied it in the ICSE curriculum in India, where we typically had an English textbook which had prose and poetry, and we had, fill-in-the-blanks or short and long answers or give reasons after the chapter. And then we had a Renan Martin for the grammar, and that's pretty much, and then we had essay writing. So that's how English was taught. However, in the primary section and the lower secondary section, when they are teaching you English in IGCSE, it's not like that. They're actually delving into the subject or your knowledge of English language itself. So what they are doing is they are giving you, say, two sort of excerpts from the different authors, and they are asking you to compare the writing styles of the authors. They are asking you to point out the metaphors in a poem which has been shared. They are asking you to understand what the author was trying to say really, or who do they think the poet was writing this poem for. And so as you can understand from the type of questions I'm saying, these are all, they don't have one right answer. They're really asking for opinions and perspectives, and really are checking how much you have really understood, what is happening in a certain prose or poetry. And even when it's a writing assignment, then they are asking you to write, say, the starting of a mystery novel. And you're being judged on using the correct language and, the right grammar, but also the kind of writing style you're using. There is something called as a PEE technique, which they judge you on, which is, you make a point, you give an example, and then you elaborate on that, you explain. So the PEE technique, so how well you can use this, and so they judge you on that as to, so this was fascinating. So when my children were doing their assignments, so unlike exams, which take place in your, typical ICSE curriculum, where you have your units and then you have your first term examination or your finals, how it works over here is that you have 4 weeks of lesson plans for the subject, and at the end of that you have an assignment. So in English, for example, either it could be a reading assignment where, as I mentioned, that you had the extract and you were supposed to point out the writing style or, give your opinion on something. Or it is a writing assignment and you're supposed to write out the starting of a mystery novel, or it is a podcast which you have to create, giving your opinion on something. Or my younger son had to create a podcast where he had to be reading out like a news anchor about an asteroid which was going to hit Earth in the next 24 hours. And he was judged on his, pronunciation and the English language and grammar itself, but also voice intonations. And was he able to understand the tone which should be used? Was he persuasive? Was he able to communicate the urgency of the situation? And he was judged on that. So this is a completely different way of, learning. And I think it's much more interesting too. So this is the favorite part. My kids really love the way English is being approached. Also science and math and geography and history. Geography, you're not needing to mug up your your states or your map. They give the atlas to you, but then they're asking you to point out places from there and compare and see that if these are the two places which are in the same biomes, then why are they different? The assignments in geography, for example, are a report which you need to create after research searching on the different biomes and choosing which would be your favorite biome to live in and giving your reasons. Now, what they are doing very intelligently is that if your child is researching the biomes, then choosing their favorite one, giving reasons why, and explaining that, then effectively what they've made you do is that made you learn about all the biomes and, in detail, because when you're giving an explanation as to why you're picking something and how it's better, then you're getting into the depth anyways, and they made you research. So they're doing pretty much the same thing, but instead of having you mug up a certain specific extract from one textbook, they just opened up that vista and made you take ownership of the topic. In science, they have the written assignments, which are pretty much like a science exam, but they also have a practical exam. Again, a subtle difference here, which I noticed and I would like to share, is that in the instructions which were given, and I mentioned this because my elder son was very fascinated by this, that the instructor had mentioned in the instructions that, you need to do your best and try to, do the experiment. Don't be disheartened if you don't get the desired results and, when you add the active yeast and it does not, cause bubbles to happen, because I'm really bad at it. I somehow can't get it to work for me. But if it doesn't work for you, I want you to mention the reasons why it didn't work or, what could have gone wrong. So again, what the instructor is doing is taking away the pressure from the performance of something which may not be in your control, but he is still able to evaluate your understanding of the concept, because if you are able to explain that which variable went wrong and why the active yeast wouldn't work, then he knows that you know your concept. So the assessment is what is really primarily different in the how the studies happen. The math also has a textbook, but it also has videos which really explain them. And they have quizzes and fun games for your tables and your factorization and all that, which make it a little interesting and give you practice while you're having fun. So that's how they approach math. The assignments there are pretty much like a question paper, obviously, for math. What you then do is after the assignment, your tutor sends you back a detailed feedback where it is not a tick and cross, but in blue, they highlight the parts which they liked what you did or you did that correct. And they also mention what you did correct. So in English, for example, if they liked your use of a certain language or a style which you mentioned, then they will highlight that. And then they will mention something, in another color, which will show that how you could have gotten a better grade or how you could have done this better. So the student really knows what he did right, which he should continue doing, and also where he could have done better. So it's not really demotivating because there's no red cross across something saying that you're completely wrong and, you have to do correction 3 times. So that's how the how to study is different. And that was the reason why I chose this. Coming up in the next part is one of the W's.